Hey guys, welcome to another how-to episode from Mwave, where we will be showing you how to install, upgrade, and initialize an M.2 device. Now, if your device is already installed and you are just looking for the initialization process, check out the timestamps and you can cut straight to the chase. First things first, let's power down our system. Once it is powered down, we do want to turn the power supply off and also unplug the system. There is still some remaining power inside our system, so we just want to push the power button down a few times just to drain anything left in there. Now we do need to pick which M.2 slot we are going to use for our device today, and there is a few things for us to consider. For instance, some slots are actually disabled with older generation CPUs, we have different speeds to consider, and some slots also share lanes with the SATA ports on the side, so if you are unsure about any of these things, I do recommend just checking your motherboard manual. Now, I am familiar with this motherboard and we do have three M.2 slots to choose from and they have similar speeds. So for our device today, we are going to be utilizing the top slot. Even though for our case today, we can access the top slot with the graphics card installed, it might be different for you, so I do recommend removing the graphics card to just give yourself a little bit of extra room to work with, make your life a bit easier. To remove the heatsink, simply unscrew any M.2 screws which are attached. There can be one or two. For our instance, say there is just a single one screw. So just unscrew that and remove the heatsink. Now, if it is the first time that the specific M.2 slot is being used, chances are you will find some protective film on both the heatsink and on the motherboard slot as well. So do make sure we remove these before installing our device. Once the protective film is removed, it is time to install our M.2 device. Now do make sure there is a standoff in the correct position, which is determined by the length of the device being used, okay? Once we're ready, simply insert it into the slot at about a 30 degree angle. You will notice it just clicks in a little bit. Push it down and make sure it lines up with the standoff there. Make sure you do have an additional M.2 screw handy. Now these do come with the motherboard and we need them to actually screw our M.2 device into place as the heatsink will not always keep it secure, okay? Once the device is secured, reinstall the heatsink and re-screw all the screws that were removed. If you did remove the graphics card during the installation of the M.2 device, now is the time to reinstall it. That's it for the installation of our M.2 device. However, we do still have to initialize it before we can use it, so let's jump into the OS and I'll show you how it's done. Once you are in your OS, the system won't recognize your drive as it has not yet been initialized. To do this, open up Disk Management by right-clicking on the Start menu and selecting Disk Management. A message will automatically pop up asking you to initialize your new drive before Disk Manager can access it. If you are using Windows 10 or a newer operating system, then make sure GPT is selected. Once you're ready, hit OK. We now need to scroll down and find our new drive, which will still be unallocated. Click on the drive and hit Create New Simple Volume. Press next twice as we do want to leave it as a default size, and then if you'd like, you can select the letter for your new drive. Finally, we do want to give our drive a quick format even if it is brand new. Format the drive with the following settings, making sure that NTFS is selected and the allocated unit size is default. We can rename our drive if you'd like. For this tutorial, we're going to call it New M.2 Device. Make sure Perform a Quick Format is selected, then hit Next. We will get a pop-up summing up everything we've selected, and if we're happy, then hit Finish. After a few seconds, your new drive will be ready to go, and you can access it from your File Explorer. And that's it for today's episode. If you do have any questions about the installation of an M.2 device or the initialization process, let me know in the comments below. And if there's anything you'd like to learn, you're not too sure how to, anything PC related, also let me know and I'll look into it for you. As always, thanks for watching.